Meanwhile, in an exclusive interview to NDTV Profit, the Central Board of Direct Taxes Chairman SSN Murthy spoke exhaustively on the Vodafone tax case, saying that this verdict would have no impact on India's ability to attract foreign investment. Here's a slice of that interview.
A very important day, you are in the commercial capital, and the day when the department is all set to pass the important order on the high-profile Vodafone case. How important this case would be for the department when it comes to the M&A activities in the country?
This is a landmark case where otherwise the normal taxation would have taken care of. But because of the volume of transaction and the tax involved, it went into various layers of litigation and all that. And we are happy the Honorable Supreme Court has justified our stand. And now we will proceed as per the directions of the court in the right direction. And a number of companies which have similar transactions which are in the pipeline already, they will be subjected to taxation as per the provisions of law. I will not comment anything upon the apportionment aspect, because one thing, the assessing officer is deciding the issue today.
As you were mentioning, would this case in that sense give a huge flip for some of the other cases like Aventis Sanofi, the Tata AT&T deal which is pending in the Bombay High Court? And also, do we see a much more vigorous persuasion from the department side when it comes to litigation with the corporate, because there's a lot many lakhs of crores of worth cases pending in various courts?
No. See, these are a select few cases where transactions of this kind are being pursued by the department. So, department's stand always has been that these are all taxable transactions in India, which the taxpayer assessees, they used to contest, saying that there is no taxability in India. And now we have come to a reasonable finality, and we will pursue those cases.
When it comes to the Vodafone case, the general feeling, the statement that have been coming out is this case would send a negative signal when it comes to foreign investments flowing into India. So what is that, if any foreign investors listening to this interview, that you would like to say as a CBDT chairman? What does this case mean, and how it would in a turn not change anything when it comes to foreign attraction of FII inflows into the country?
See, number one, we have not gone against any provision of law. We have only implemented the existing provisions of law. So far, so good. Number two, regarding foreign investment, if you examine the statistics of investment which has come into India during last 1 year, when the case is going on, you can see there is a monumental increase. The investment has not gone down. In fact, compared to maybe 8, 9, 10 has been, the investment has been much more. So which shows, in spite of Vodafone, the inflow has been much, much bigger.